As you continue to play this woman, how have you grown even more fond of her than what initially sparked your interest?
She has proven to be so incredibly strong. Every episode I sit down and I like work on the script and I look at the choices she makes, and I'm always like, her honesty and like her communicativeness, and there's just a strength that she has. And even with Vincent, who I think at times wants to bail on stuff, she's always there going like, we can do this and it's possible and we're gonna fight for it. And it's not very often that her faith in that wavers. And yes, it comes from like a tortured kind of place, but that aspect of her I love so much.
You said work on the script, as in just reading it, or do you actually get to contribute to what's happening?
I do contribute. I like send my thoughts on almost every episode.
Oh, wow.
I work a lot on the scripts. And when I mean that from an actor perspective.
Right.
As well. Our pace is so fast that I don't have the luxury of spending as much time as I would like, but mm-hmm. But I go through the entire thing and I really find, like, if it's something doesn't work for me or doesn't make sense, like, I talk about it and we're very collaborative about that stuff.
How's that paid off for you? Like, can you tell me, do you have like a specific example of where you like kind of targeted something and they said, oh, we get that?
You know, there's a lot of examples. I'm trying to think of something super specific, but I think that it's reflected in the entire arc of the character. I think it's just a collaborative environment to build Catherine, and I have never experienced that before in that way. You know, I wish I could give you something more specific. I'm sorry.
How do you think this Beauty and the Beast is separated from every other Beauty and the Beast we've seen? Because, I mean, we've seen lots of versions of the story before. What do you think your story does that the others haven't been able to do?
You know, I think this story is telling the same story, ultimately. I feel like we're still looking at love and love in its purest form, and what does that look like, and how do you get there, and how does love help you find your humanity? Like, I feel like that's all very much the same themes. I feel like we're looking at it in a much more... The mythology is much more dense, I think, in our version.
Okay.
Because if you look at other Beauty and the Beast, like, It's normally a tale that, except for the series, the 80s series, it's a tale that kind of has a beginning, middle, and end,
mm-hmm.
and it's kind of a morality story in a way. But ours has a lot more like layers and roots, I think, that hasn't been done before. It's a little darker too, I think.
Have you pitched ideas for another season?
I've been asked that a few times today. It's weird. We're in the second to last episode, and my brain is so focused on like where the character is at now that I haven't really sat down to vision out where I think she would go.
Mm-hmm.
Our cliffhanger is pretty big at the end of the season, as it is. like to figure out where it would go next season is kind of a big task in my brain that I can't get to yet.
What can you sort of tease about the remaining episodes?
Well, since we've moved away from the procedural, everything is about kind of escalating with these characters. So Tess knows about Vincent now. Evan is on a mission. Gabe's involved and we don't quite know what's going on with him. Muirfield is closing in. Everything's kind of escalating. There's going to be big reveals about Catherine's family, how they're involved in everything, and kind of where the organization is at. Every episode is like bigger than the one before it. Like, it's just a lot of stuff is happening.
So you're in almost every scene, and you said you're almost done. What are you looking forward to doing?
Oh, sleeping. Sleeping in the nighttime. I'm so excited for that. I think I'm going to have a little vacation. Toronto's been cold. It's been cold, but you know, it's been good, but I'm tired. I forget how exhausting it is.
Can I remember it from the TCAs where you were saying this was really like your first sort of breakaway on your own, like living situation where you were just like free to do whatever you wanted? And
yes, I maybe I did say that. I mean, that's true.
What's the time been like? Have you had been like self discovery time?
No, it's been discover Catherine Chandler. I might know her better than I know me at this point. But that's what it's been. I mean, like, if I'm just really honest, I went grocery shopping once this month. You know, like, it's been busy.
If Pat could go back and kind of maybe alter an event that's happened, what would she change?
That's an interesting question. I think Catherine in her head would want to not have her mom die, but I don't think she realizes how much that event has made her into the force of nature that she is, in my head anyway. But I think she would never want, that's her entire drive, is to never have that happen to anybody else. And every person that she loves, she's trying to stop that from happening to. So if she could change that, I think she would.
Is there a character maybe this season who she wish doesn't know about her and Vincent?
Well, I think Catherine beats herself up because she feels like she should have told everybody, but she couldn't, and like it's a big struggle for her because she sees her responsibility and everything that happens to each of those characters. But I think that once we get back after this little hiatus, when you see what happens with Evan finding out, I think that's, him and the way that he takes all of the information, I think, is the hardest for her.
So does she feel more of a burden that Tess knows now, or
it's a relief and it's a burden? But in some ways, it's easier because if someone knows, you can actually protect them better because you can be direct with them about, you can't go there because of this really horrible organization that like is going to destroy everything and everybody on the planet, you know? Whereas before, it had to be all tentative. But it's nice for her to have a friend.
How tough of a choice was it for you to do another series?
It was tough. And it really was, like I was saying, last year. It really is about Sherry and Jennifer for me that I chose to do this show. And I've been really lucky with the cast and the environment. Jay is so good. He's so fun to work with. He's so talented. And Nina and I have become incredibly close friends. And I think that relationship kind of comes across on the screen. Because the way that Tess and Catherine are kind of the way that me and Nina are. So that's been really rewarding for me.
When it comes to the action element, is there something that you, Kristin, have taken from having that physical discipline, and maybe do you feel more confident that you can do stuff, or do you feel like, I'm still just an actor and this is like...
I could never really... I was actually just joking last night. We were shooting a fight scene, and Kim, who's been my double since Smallville, we've been working... She's been my fight double forever, and she kind of does it... Anyway, we were joking, and I was like, I feel like one day I'll just go in the street, and I'll be like, if I go like that to you, and you don't go, oh, I'll be so confused. Really? Like, what are you doing? Like, why are you touching me there? It's really not scary at all.
Well, you were saying that working with Jay has been a pleasure. Is there stuff that goes on behind the scenes that fans don't get to see that really shows the connection between you two?
I think that our whole cast has this wonderful connection. We're the silliest people you could ever meet. There's a lot of singing. There's a lot of dancing. There's a lot of musical singing. It's just silly. It's pure silliness. And I think that we're really, there's a deep trust, and I don't know how we got it, and I don't know how we built it, but I feel so lucky that it's there. It's really great.
When do we get a musical episode?
Yeah.
Guys, never. I can't sing. Everyone else on the cast is a decent singer, not me. Bad.